The game view in Unity is invoked when the play button is pressed. In this, you can playtest your game and get an idea of what the gameplay will be like when it's built. This can be paused and stepped forward at any time, in order to give you more accurate testing. You can also tweak things whilst you're in play mode in order to see what the gameplay is like with different settings. The game view also allows you to set resolution specific to the target platform that you're using. For example, I'm set to standalone with a resolution of 1280 by 720. If I choose to then maximize on play, the game view will restrict to exactly that resolution so that I can see what it will look like. To adjust this, I go to Edit, Project Settings, Player, and this shows me the default screen width and height under Resolution. If I edit this, I will see the change made immediately in the game view. And if I choose to switch to a different target platform, I will get the resolution for that setting. For example, if I switch to Web Player and return, Web Player is then featured as the target platform I'm building for, and the preview mode for the game view. In addition to maximize on play, the game view also has a stats button to allow you to see performance statistics based on your game, and also the ability to show gizmos in the same way that the scene view shows them already. As you can adjust things whilst in play mode, you should also be aware that any changes that you make will be undone when returning to your project. This is specific to changes that are based on game objects in your scene, and not game objects that reference assets in the project. For example, if I was to change something relating to a material, that change is made to the original asset, whereas if I was to change something on a specific component, that thing will be undone when play is pressed again. It's also worth being aware that when you press play, your game is running, and you can hint this by going to Unity Preferences, or Edit Preferences on PC. You can choose under Colors a play mode tint. I've chosen a shade of blue, but I can make this any color that I need to. That way, when you press play, the rest of the interface will change to this color. This is to remind you that you're in play mode, and will lose changes if you continue to work in that.